So let's see here, what is Proxmox firewall and how we can get the security stuff out of it on the Proxmox VM environment. So the security is the most important nowadays, so how we can implement that here. So let's understand what is exactly is the firewall and how we can do that. So if you see that, what exactly is the firewall? So firewall is a example. Firewall is a well-being network framework that screens and controls moving ever closer affiliation traffic dependent upon distinct security rules. So we have the security rule, and it has some framework to screen incoming and outgoing traffic. Then let's inspect the packets and say that okay, so this packet is going over there, over here, and based on the rules, example, say that so. And example, say you allow the port number 80, then it only allow the traffic through that port number 80, but it does not block the traffic on the 80 port. So whatever you sent on the 80 port, it just sent and received that. So, but whatever the remaining ports you dropped it so that it won't have a traffic sent or received. So whatever the traffic is sent on that port numbers, that would be blocked on the firewall. So that is the simple mechanism the firewall do. So in PVE firewall, the Proxmox Virtual Environment firewall provides an easy way to protect your IT infrastructure. You can set up firewall rules for all the hosts inside a cluster, or define the rules for virtual machines and containers as well. So it's example there that the object level you can put the firewall rules. So that's the granular firewall rules you can apply to. Okay, and example say that so it can be applied on the data center level, it can be applied on the host level, it can be applied on the containers level, it can apply on the virtual machines level. So that this many firewall rules you can apply it on the multi layers so that it can have a secured environment. If you just like firewall macros, you already have some macros defined. If you want to enable some of the already existing port numbers or the services, you can just select that micro, so it will automatically do that. Security groups, so you can create multiple security groups and assign those security groups to the resources or the group so that the whatever the security groups rules has, it will be applied. IP sets, aliases help to make that task easier. You can define object level firewall rules. That's the major security here. So firewall config files, so these are the major three files which will actually write the rules over there. Slash etc slash pve firewall slash cluster dash fw slash etc slash pve slash node slash node name slash host dot fw, and here slash etc slash pve firewall slash vm id number, example 100.101.102, something like that dot fw. So this is where your actual firewall rules will be stored. Okay, let's see the console and see how we can write the rules and see how it works. So we are here on the cluster, and you can see that if you click on the data center level, there is a firewall. So the firewall has the options to enable and disable, and you can create the security groups, aliases, IP sets here. So firewalls, and you can also go on the host level, there is a firewall, and this also has some options and log information. And if you go to the container level, this also some has some firewall, and you can also write the options, aliases, all these rules on the container level as well. Okay, let's see here on the data center level, we write a few rules and see how it works. So first of all, do not enable the firewall. First write the rules, then enable the firewall. Otherwise, it by default it has a rule that drop everything and accept. So that's why if you put anything here, so it will be dropped everything, so you lose the connectivity to your SSH and web console. So that's why you am putting this accept here and say 8006 is allowed anywhere. So I do not have any source or destination defined here so that it will be open to the everyone. So TCP port number 8006 accept, and add another rule and in accept and say here. So what you want to allow here, so the network name is VM bridge 0, and here maybe I can enable SSH so that I can able to SSH the PVE, and select here the micro. So the micro is already have. So if you select the micro, this port type and the port number will be disabled so that it will automatically enable that related port number. Okay, and the source this time I enable from this source only allow SSH. Okay, this IP series, source IP series. Now say that's it and add the rule. So SSH rule also is going to be added on the firewall, and tick mark here as I enable the rule so that it will enable here. You can see. Okay, let's edit here. So I did not I am adding the one more rule, so maybe it's ICMP to ping the host. So enable the ping, and you have to add always the network card name here, the network name, otherwise it won't actually work the firewall rule. And this time again I am enabling the source is my desktop network. And I say here add. So as of now I added the 8006 port number and SSH and ICMP. Now go ahead and options and say firewall on here, and maybe I just put some ping here and see how it goes. Okay, 192.168.29.250 and continuous ping to that host. So it is pinging, and now if you enable the rule, so does it drop or not? So that's it, that's a observation. You can see I can connect to the so SSH to the server and see whether the SSH will drop or not. Okay, so this is two I'm checking here, so whether they drop or stay. And firewall and enable tick mark, click OK, and now I can go ahead and see that. Okay, my console is working fine because I already enabled 8006 port number here, and see, you can see the ping is still continuing. And if you go to the, let's again maybe press Ctrl C and restart this ping and see it is pinging or not. Okay, it's pinging, and let, you can see that SSH is still on, so that our firewall rules is working fine on the data center level. So maybe you can edit this rules and add some of them a different way. Okay, maybe you can put it as trap, something like that. I can see that ICMP drop and enable, but this data center level, if you put a drop on this, oh, it does not work actually, because you have to put the drop on the host level. To stop this ping, you have to actually put this ICMP rule on the drop level, because this is on cluster. If you apply the data center level, this is applicable to the cluster, all the nodes, not to the particular node, so that it does not work in that way. Maybe you have to add the rule on the host level, so the drop will work on that host level. Sometimes it takes a little more time to apply the firewall rules. Okay, then that time it might work for some time, then you may have to retest it back, it is working fine or not. So now let's go to the firewall rules here on the host level and say drop, and I put it as the VM bridge 0 here and drop the ICMP here. Let's see how that is, how does this work. And so I'm drop creating the drop to the all the host, all the networks. So there is no actually source. It should actually drop the ICMP, which means ping should be dropped. You cannot ping the host. Again, I'm adding one more rule here. So let's see here. Maybe I can add TCP here 8006 and say enable 8006 on the PV1. So I am adding one more rule here, maybe HTTP SSH here. HTTP HTTPS also you can add it here. So I am allowing the SSH here from the host level. You can see there are three rules written. I now go ahead and enable the firewall on the host level. So actually it does not drop any ping or does not drop any options here. You can see I still put some drop, but it does not do it. So maybe it takes some time to apply the firewall rules on the host level. Maybe I can remove this data center rule, like allowing the ICMP here, and let's see how that goes. So now let's delete this rule, and I only have the rule on the PVE host saying that drop the ICMP packets, so it should not ping the network. You can see here I deleted both of them, enable the firewall and added the rule it back saying that drop the connection and test it. So that should be work. I can see there is no rule, so both the rules I have deleted from data center as well as from the host. You can see firewall is enabled. Now let's try to ping here. So it does not work. See that it's I could not able to ping to the host. It's a request time dot. So that's how the firewall actually works on the Proxmox.
For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications.